insects have a part to play in the maintenance of healthy ecosystems. However, at high population densities, these insects can cause serious damage to plants that are used by humans for food and fiber production. Despite control efforts, insect pests destroy more than 15% of potential worldwide crop production every year, and are therefore some of our biggest competitors for food. Billions of dollars are spent annually to control herbivorous insects, and they regularly cause significant economic loss. Invasive herbivorous insects in particular have important economic impacts in agriculture. The spread of such invasive species has been driven by many factors, including the modern technological revolution. With increased globalization and ease of travel, insects that avoid detection can be transported all over the world. Invasive species can threaten biodiversity, and the damage they cause to crops can be extensive compared to native species. This is especially true if a host plant has not had the chance to co-evolve with an invasive herbivore, or if natural predators are not yet adapted to feed on the invasive species. A current ecological disaster in the Mississippi River Delta is the result of an invasive scale insect that feeds on Roseau cane, a common marshland plant. The feeding damage caused by the invasive insect threatens coastal restoration efforts to protect shipping channels, shrimp fishing grounds, and oil extraction activities along the Louisiana coastline. Besides the introduction and spread of invasive insect species, there are other human-based activities that can promote populations of both native and invasive herbivorous insects to greater pest status. In managed ecosystems, plant monocultures can dominate the landscape as a result of planting preferences and the reliance on mechanized agriculture by humans. Monocultures reduce the natural plant diversity in a region, as only a single plant species is planted over a large area that would otherwise support a great diversity. Even within a single crop species, the genetic diversity of a monoculture can be further limited through the selection of certain crop varieties. This provides a great resource for insect herbivores that are able to utilize the chosen plant. Monoculture plantings also support a lower diversity and abundance of predators and parasitoids that feed on insect herbivores. More food and fewer enemies can lead to a population boom for the insect herbivore that can ravage the crop and the resource being harvested. A good example of monoculture practices that resulted in massive pest outbreaks is the wide-scale production of cotton. By planting only a single species of crop over large areas, the oversimplified agroecosystem promoted the invasion and outbreak of a destructive pest, the cotton boll weevil, to the southern United States. At peak populations in the 1970s, feeding damage caused by the cotton boll weevil cost U.S. cotton producers around $200 million every year. Although the cotton boll weevil has been eradicated in almost all cotton-growing states in the U.S., this pest remains a concern and is carefully monitored to prevent reintroduction. The economic impact of insect herbivores isn't all doom and gloom, however, as some herbivorous insects can be beneficial control agents of weeds. For example, in the 1940s, about 2.5 million acres of California rangeland was covered by a noxious weed, the European St. John's wort. The weed is toxic to livestock and outcompetes native rangeland vegetation. To manage the spread of this noxious weed, an herbivorous beetle, Chrysolina quadrigemina, the Klamath weed beetle, was introduced into the state. It became established in the region and has since been effectively controlling weed populations. This, in turn, led to the restoration of the native plant species composition across the rangelands. We will discuss the use of insects in weed biological control and pest management in a later module.